Hey guys, LampinAnyTV again today with episode 47 of Coin Collector. And as I said in the last episode from yesterday, this is going to be a trading only video because I definitely need some more coins to build a kind of super team I want to use in the 11 League tournament, the Team of the Week tournament, in which you get, I think, 10,000 coins if you win it online. And then I think you also get kind of into a draw in which you can probably win the whole Team of the Week, which sounds kind of cool. Don't know exactly how they're going to do that. As you can see on the screen right now, almost every player of my squad sold, except for Neymar, of course, who I didn't sell because I wanted to keep him. And I had around 275,000 coins, and I thought I needed about 350,000 coins, so that makes around 75,000 coins I needed to make. And what I actually want to talk about in this episode, as you can see, as always, the players I paid the prices for them and the prices I sold them for. You can of course see that on the screen right now. And what I wanted to talk about actually is the change of inform players prices, and that can you probably see like on an example here. For example, the inform Honda got up in price. He used to go for around 80,000 coins a couple of weeks ago. Same goes with that James Rodriguez, who went for like 20,000 to 25,000 coins a couple of weeks ago after he was released. Now he's going for around 35,000 coins, even in the center attacking midfielder position. Same with this Gibbs here. His price fluctuates kind of a lot. He was going for 40,000 coins a couple of weeks back. And same goes with the Berbatov as well, whose price went up. And now these are, of course, almost all BPL players. And just to remind you, inform players' prices can change quite a lot, and you can definitely make some profit on that if you want to say it like that, do long-term trading. And what I mean by that is you buy an inform player of which you think who is good, who is wanted by the people on the market, and then you just wait and wait a couple of weeks after he has been released, and then of course no more cards of him are released on the market because he's out of packs after 1 week. And so he gets more rare on the market as people just keep him in their squads or keep him in their club or whatever. And so the prices can, I think, only go up on at least some of the players, like BPL players. And there definitely is some profit to be made. I personally don't really like doing that because, it takes time to make this profit. It takes 2 or 3 weeks or so until you can sell the players for actual profit. And the longer you wait sometimes, the more profit you can, of course, make. But I'm all about the quick profits. And as you can see on your screen right now, just training the low plate, I said this method in a couple of episodes ago, just to get a little bit more coins, a couple of thousand coins more or less. It's always better to have more of them. And I had some time, so I did this method as well, which of course gets tiresome after some time because you have to look up the players' prices always to get the best profit out of them. This Weidenfeller here actually sold for 30,000 coins, I think, in the end, just because it's in the 4-3-3 formation. So as always, for me, formation is very key. And as you could see earlier, though, once again talking back about the inform players, the inform Adriano, the left back from Barcelona, didn't go up in price, and I think I know why. And I just want to give you an idea of why he didn't go up in price, and then you can probably judge on your own which players will go up or not. So Adriano is only, I think, 76 overall rated, which isn't the greatest. And first of all, Brazilian left backs in the in general, you have got, of course, Marcelo and Felipe Luis, and they also play in the Liga BBVA, so there is a lot of challenge if you want to say that, for people to actually get the Adriano, because Marcelo is much better stat wise than there's Felipe Luis, who's first of all a lot cheaper and then still better than Adriano. And there's of course the inform Felipe Luis, who I actually don't know how much he goes for. So Adriano doesn't get picked too often as a left back. And then in general in the Liga BBVA, of course, you have the likes of Jordi Alba or the inform Jordi Alba. If you, like, for example, build a Barcelona squad, you will definitely go for him instead of Adriano. So I think that kind of explains why his price didn't go up, in contrast to other players whose prices did go up, like, for example, the inform Henry, who is very wanted, probably the best striker in the MLS you can get there, and also a good French striker and kind of a legend in real life. And this Altidor here, his price didn't go up just because I think his stats aren't the greatest. So I hope you can kind of judge on your own which players' prices can go up if you do indeed want to make profit that way. As you can see, could see briefly there though, the Van Buyten in the 4-1-2-1-2 formation sold for a nice profit, even though he only has 29 pace, which once again shows that this method kind of works for almost every player. This is actually the end of this episode, guys. As you can now see in the top right-hand corner, I do have over 350,000 coins, so a very nice and profitable episode this was. Sorry if I rambled on a little bit, and I hope you did at least understand a little bit what I meant by the kind of price changes of the informed players. If it helped you or if you enjoyed this episode, then please feel free to leave a like. As always, it is greatly appreciated. Other than that, thanks a lot once again for watching this video, and I will talk to you later.